Hello, YouTube. Daddy Leroy here once again. Been a week since I put up a video. It's just been busy. But I thought I'd jump up here right quick and answer the question that I asked in my last video. The question was, what did John Wayne do for the first time in Wake of the Red Witch that he did in every single movie that he made after that? Now, that video where I asked that question got 18 hits and only one person even attempted to answer. And that was a good guess, Keith. But Wake of the Red Witch came out in 1948. John Wayne didn't establish his production company until 1953 or 4. I don't remember right now. At any rate, that didn't come till later. The answer is that in Wake of the Red Witch and in every movie that he made afterwards for the rest of his career, John Wayne wore a toupee. Almost forgot my housekeeping. Smoking my Dr. Grebo Grand Duke and in it. I don't know if you can see this very well. The light out here is bad, but smoking Cornell and Deals, easy times. Thin note on this tobacco, Latakia. That's about all I get smelling it in the tin. When you first light it, that's the dominant flavor you get. It's made up of Virginia, Latakia, and 20-year-old aged dark-fired burley. Like I said, when you first light it up, all you taste is Latakia. As you smoke it on down, take your time with it, which I'm puffing on this pretty hard, but if you take your time with it, you start to get a little bit of the sweetness from the Virginia. If I'm tasting the burley, I don't know it. It seems to be hidden in the background there somewhere. But it is pretty tasty. I mean, it's not bad. It's not quite what I expected. But it's not bad. It's growing on me. The more I learn how this tobacco likes to be smoked. Don't pack this one loose. I packed it loose the first few times I smoked it. It got hot. Bit my tongue. I started packing it a little firmer. Keeping it well tamped all the time. It slows down the burn and get more flavor out of it. It is definitely pretty strong. It's it won't just knock you out. But it's definitely not for the beginner. It is sort of a it's a stronger flavor. But I like it. Back when I was chewing tobacco, I used to chew some pretty strong tobaccos, and it reminds me some of those. Bloodhound. Brown's Mule. Cannonball. I tell you this. You smoke a bowl of this, your wife's not going to want to kiss you. It leaves that strong smell on you. I don't consider this an all-day smoke. I usually come out here on the front porch in the evening after we get my little boy in the bed. Wife's in the bedroom watching TV. I'll come out here and sit on the porch and have a smoke and just kind of wind down. That's a good time to smoke this. Because I'll smoke a bowl of this and I'll go in the house and take a shower. But yeah. Oh, something else I wanted to do this time around. I wanted to thank all my subscribers. I really appreciate all you folks and thanks for hanging in there with me. I know I don't get to put up videos all that often sometimes, and I guess I'm not that terribly entertaining, but for those of you that do watch, I appreciate it. It's amazing to me that anybody wants to hear what I have to say. But apparently some of you do. I guess that's really about all I had. This time I don't have a trivia question for you this week. I don't know. I may come up with one and try to make another video tomorrow or something. I'll have to think about it a little while. Anyway, with that, until next time.